Hello, Pisces. Let's get you your September 2022 reading. Spirit, what do we have for the collective of Pisces for September 2022? Show us chakra energies, please. Chakra energies. Chakra energies. Page of Wands, good news. Knight of Cups, also good news, soulmate. So I'm seeing two messages, and now you're confused. Okay, so you have a lot of options. And you don't like them. Okay, so solar plexus chakra, you have a lot of options. Heart chakra, you're kind of not satisfied with what you're being offered. You're not satisfied with your soulmate. And the truth is, you're confused because of too many options. And also, other people are involved. Okay, people just couldn't mind their business. And your plan, what's in your head, is to cut these people off so that you'll gain clarity. That's in your mind, okay? And crowning this is the Hermit card, which simply means that you're gonna be, you know, on hermit mode. You won't be talking to a lot of people until the time that you gain enlightenment or you've figured things out. So you're studying your situation. Okay, so that could mean that you're connecting with a Virgo. Okay, so people are involved. You don't like the feeling. Okay, you're still looking at the past events that happened. Okay. I'm gonna try to sit comfortably. So, there's going to be two messages, and you're going to be just confused, and just as you don't like the messages that you're getting, and it's going to cause a lot of confusion. People are starting to talk. Okay. So it's like you're connecting with a person who's very quiet. So you might communicate with them, but they're not going to respond. Or that would be you. People are communicating to you and you're not responding. Is that the devil card? Hope not. Okay, Spirit, show us life, career, and love for the collective of Pisces. Ten of Wands. So, you're burdened by this situation. But the good news is, you're going to drop the burden. Because you want to be happy. Ten of Cups. Watch out for 10-10. Okay. Four of Swords. Because you want some peace. Peace and quiet. That's what you want. Or this person does. The person that you're connecting with. Okay. In your career, there's a blessing coming with the Wheel of Fortune. Wheel is turning to your favor, but what? Friends, family? Okay. So, the blessing could be a person from work. that is giving you something you like. Could be an Aquarius, King of Swords. This is a person in the government, military, or something legal, or something with authority. Ah. So some of you might receive an award, maybe for a good job. Because I see work here, a lot of work. Okay. This could also mean someone is returning from work. Which is a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, or a fixed sign. Aquarius, strong Aquarius here, Scorpio, Taurus. That card wanted to come out. You have the Three of Pentacles for your love spread. Okay, I'm not done with the finance yet. We'll get back to it. King of Cups. So your person might be a water sign. You want to work with this water sign. Okay. Someone from the past is returning. A Scorpio. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, that could be your person, or this could be you, Pisces, and this is your soulmate, so cups, you might have met them from work, you might have worked with them before, this water sign, so this is water, you could be connecting with a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Okay. Fellow Pisces. But there's going to be an offer in September. You're going to connect with this person. At first, it would be work-related. It would be work-related how you will connect. But nonetheless, this is Two of Cups. And you have a lot of love for this person. King of Cups is the King of Love. You have a lot of love for this person. You love this person so much. You met them at work. Okay. That's good news. And speaking of work, so this... Oh, okay, yeah. So, there. This is your soulmate at work. You've already worked with this person. You met them at work. Blessed Divine Father, what are the messages for the collective of Pisces? I see you being burdened, but after you drop this burden, this petty squabbles, you'll be happier the moment you drop the... Okay, so speaking of drop, Divine Father already spoke. Okay. Divine Other, show us some messages. What is hidden for the collective of Pisces for September 2022? Ooh, Scorpio. Virgo, Pisces, oof. Okay, all right, let's start with the Divine Father's message. Instead of praying for an outcome, I pray for the highest good of all. So what that means is, that means not to be selfish. My energy creates my reality. What I focus on is what I will manifest. Any manifestation here? So, but anyway, I think you're gonna gain enlightenment, and this, the Divine Father says, focus on what you want. Plain and simple. When I'm connected to my joyful presence, I attract support from the universe. So, the universe is gonna bring out of this confusion energy, and it will, Divine Father saying, they're going to remove anything that is hampering your joyfulness. Let's say, they, from the looks of it, they're gonna bring this person back and kind of, you know, reintegrate it, and you'll meet this person in your workplace. They could be an air sign or a water sign, or they could be a water sign with a lot of air in their chart. Okay, what else? Okay, you are good enough, full moon in Virgo. So, Pisces, this is asking the universe, telling you to have confidence. Okay, you came out. Full moon in Pisces. So there might be, you might be manifesting this by the full moon in September. Right now we have the new moon in Virgo. Virgo new moon. So there's two full moons. Oh, three full moons. You are really manifesting this. Balance, spirituality, and practicality. I do whatever it takes to get closer to consciousness. So definitely, you're going to have to meditate on this and think on this situation very clearly. Emotions are running high, supermoon. From the looks of it, you're going to cut off the BS on this situation. Let's say if you have a work situation where people are so negative and people are nosy, you're going to cut them off. Drop the burdens, do self-reflection, and then you will realize what you really want. And what's in front of you, you had the soulmate right in front of you all that time. And finally, you recognize that. And from here, the Scorpio card here, it's time to release negativity, full moon in Scorpio. What did I say? You gotta get rid of these people and tell them, mind your own business. That's it. Okay. Because there's a lot of confusion. And a lot of people, like, telling you what to do. In this case, these are petty people. People who doesn't have your best interest at heart. So, like I've been telling the collective for the past few readings I've done, you need to find the answers for yourself. The Hermit card has been coming up, popping out a lot of times. So the Divine is asking you to meditate and contemplate. Drop the burdens, release. Release the negativity. All right. And they're also asking you to be confident, because you don't need to get emotional about the situation. Don't let your emotions get the better of you. you might be kind of nervous because this person gives you the butterflies because you like them so much, you love them so much, you're kind of shy. But the offer is going to be coming in. You'll meet this person, you'll talk to this person, and you will work with this person. Okay, so signs I'm seeing here is Virgo, Pisces, Scorpio, strong Scorpio. Okay. Yeah. Could be a Leo as well, and an Aquarius. But definitely strong Scorpio and Virgo. Okay. All right. Any messages? Anything else? So don't be confused. Don't be confused by other people. Okay. Try to filter it out. With the Queen of Swords here, see, these are petty people. The Queen of Swords, she's not looking at them anymore. She's looking at this hermit. And it seems like they're having a conversation. Okay, someone's going to clarify something and someone's going to be offering a helping hand. Okay, so I think you're trying to balance. This is what. Okay, so this card landed on these cards, and it says here, balance spirituality and practicality. The Hermit is spiritual, and the Queen of Swords is practical, and fair. So this is the symbol of balance, of practicality and spirituality. Oh my goodness. You're a divine pair, King and Queen of Swords. King and Queen of Swords. So most likely the logic part got the best out of the both of you. But you are water sign, so you don't operate in logic. You're on creative emotion. That's how you connect. So, yeah. Like I said, you're gonna meet this person at work. This person, your soulmate, is at work. Okay? All right. So any other messages? So there's good news coming. An offer from a soulmate and a good news in work. You'll find that out in September. Okay. Right. Okay. I think that's it. Hopefully this gives you clarity, and if it does resonate, please feel free to comment down below, give us a like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, check us on our socials, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, and also products and services are available in Lazada, Shopee, and Shopbox. Donations, link down below for PayPal. Alright, so I hope you enjoyed this reading. Thank you for watching, Pisces. I hope to see you on your next Samurai Tarot reading. That will be on October. Bye.